Cool. Thanks, Zach. All right. I'm going to kick it off and then turn it over to Skyler. So, hey, Visa, I'm very excited to be here and have the opportunity to talk to you all about programming the Fed and the clearinghouse. I'm Ben. I work in the product org, and I'll be handing it over to Skyler in a little bit to do a technical demo. Before I do, a touch of context, and we did weave in some 80s movie humor today, so you'll see a couple nuggets coming through. So we're going to show and tell today what we did to evolve the platform to support, as Ben Millen said earlier, programmable payments. We connect businesses to banking infrastructure via powerful and flexible ACI. Skyler's going to show you in a second. And we use a cluster of transfer types and features. We're flexible. We got a rich platform. You can have collections, disbursements, stored value, and all the bells and whistles to compose and design your payments to fit your business process. How do we build this platform? We did it by listening to our customers. We're a learning organization. So Zach just mentioned a feature. We launched RTP this morning. Super excited about that. Been in the sandbox for a while. It's now in prod. Money's moving across those rails. It's great. Skyler's going to show you the lift to turn RTP on. It's dead simple. So let's talk quickly about this. We've advanced our platform to increase speed and capabilities all in the same API. You're going to see what we're doing today in the sandbox. Nothing is faked or mocked. And we had some debate about that. Skyler and I have a feature that's whipped that allows for programmatic assignment of bank account and routing numbers. And we're really proud of that. We thought about mocking it up, but we're not going to do that. Not the right thing for the audience. But that's really cool. Makes the stored value and funds and even more fast and powerful. Kind of like the Baylor game last night. Baylor overwhelmed Gonzaga. They were fast and powerful. All right. So we're going to go speed ahead here. We'd like to show the capabilities of our platform today. We're going to highlight a couple of things. Skyler is going to create a customer, upgrade the customer. That's pretty powerful. Don't miss that. Attach a funding source and fan funds out using four different transfer types. Standard ACH, same day, push to debit and RTP. And everybody, Skyler moves fast. If you don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss the funds moving. So with that, I'd like to hand it over to Skyler Nesheim, to demo we can program some payments using our sandbox. I'm going to hop in the chat box, be ready for questions, and I'll provide any highlights if necessary. So Skyler, over to you.
Thanks, Ben. Hey, everybody. I'm Skyler Nesheim. Great to meet you all. Thanks for welcoming us to VSUM. We're going to give an overview of how to program a payment on the Dwolla platform today, and we're really going to program a payment. We've brought along with us a small AI inspired by an 80s movie. If you're into those, hopefully you'll catch what we're talking about. Let me just orient you to kind of what I'm showing on my screen here. So in the upper left-hand corner, you're going to see the actual walking through of our demo. It's just a command line-based application because we want to show the simplicity in getting started and programming on the Dwolla API. Down here in the bottom part, you're going to see the actual programming and the code that's associated with this. If you're not a programmer, don't worry. I hope to make you feel like you're a programmer by the end of this and how easy it is to get going on payments. And on the right here, you're going to see the Dwolla dashboard. This is our backend administrative dashboard that we give to all the clients associated with the Dwolla platform. You can see everything that's going on in your application, all your customers, all your transfers, things of that nature. So let's kick off the demo and let's see how our AI is doing today. Well, it starts off with, shall we play a game? Love to. Know any fintech games? Wouldn't you prefer a good game of chess? Later. Let's play Global Fintech Showdown. Okay, so that's the kickoff of our API. What we're going to do next is we're going to create a customer on the Dwolla platform. That's the foundation of how you get started with programming a payment. So it's going to ask us, what's your name? Again, this is simplified for the purposes of demo, but we're going to say our name is Falcon. Now, what's going to happen is the AI or the program behind the scenes is going to go to the Dwolla API, the Dwolla platform, and create a customer. So if we step over here into the sandbox, we're going to load our customer view, and we should see our new customer, which is Falcon. Stepping into the code, what does that look like? How hard is that to do? I just showed a lot. We've created a lightweight customer on the Dwolla platform, and here's how we did it. We've got a small Python program here, and we're just providing a few pieces of information. You see we're providing a first name, a last name, email address, and an IP address. When we post this to our API, it goes and creates that customer that you're seeing on the right hand of the screen. It's a lightweight customer. This can be used to send funds to, on the Dwolla platform, but you can't do some other things. So we might want to upgrade this identity. So we see our program now, it's driving us to ask us to verify our identity. It's pretty simple to get going and do that on Dwolla. We can do that with just the last four of our SSN. So we're going to input that. Behind the scenes, the program's going to go and verify our identity. So what does it take to do that? Well, if we step through things here, let's look at the code. We need to provide an SSN, some address information, a postal code, a date of birth, and some more information. Posting the same customer endpoint, we can now watch this Falcon Dwolla customer migrate from an unverified customer to a verified one. You see the yellow box just turned green. So we're about 36 lines of code into doing something right now. We've already got a customer created in a verified state. That's really, really powerful. They're now ready to program on a lot of fintech platforms. The next piece that we need is a funding source. What's a funding source? Well, a funding source on Dwolla might be a bank account or it might be some other things that we'll talk about in just a minute. So our program's asking us, hey, would you like me to create a funding source? Yes, let's go ahead and have it create a funding source for us. What's included in that information? Well, that API call is made up of just a few pieces of information as well. A routing number, an account type, and a nickname for the account. And we'll see that published in our dashboard on the other side. Now, again, this is a lightweight funding source. It's gonna allow us to send money to the funding source. If we wanted to do more like pull money from or do other things like that, maybe authorize future payments, we can do all that through the API. It's just a few more pieces of information we need to provide in the API request. So let's step over here into the dashboard and take a look at what just happened. We're still on that customer that we created, and now we step to the funding sources. And what we'll see here is this at the bottom of the screen is this Falcon's checking, which is our checking account that we just created on the Dwolla platform. We can now use to send money to. Again, it's in an unverified state, but we can move it to another state if we wanted to. So we've got a verified customer, we've got a funding source. The next step is let's program a few different payment types. The first one we're going to program is a standard ACH transfer. So we'll go ahead and kick that process off and let's step through and see what that looks like. It's pretty simple on the Dwolla platform. To provide a payment, we just have to provide a few pieces of information. We need to provide a source, which is just a URL to the funding source the funds will be pulled from. And then we need to provide a destination, which is also a URL in our API that the funds are gonna go to. We program an amount, which includes a currency type as well as the value. And when we kick that off and do a post to our API, we'll see a transfer gets created. So back over here on our customer and Dwolla admin, we're gonna click transactions. It will pull up the view and we'll see our transaction created for $99,000. Okay, so we just did standard ACH. What about some faster payment modalities, transfer types? What about same day ACH? Well, it turns out it's pretty easy to get going with that on Dwolla as well. So we'll get our program started on our same day ACH behind the scenes. And let's look at what that looks like from a programming standpoint. What I've done here is I just want to show the things that we're changing to program same day ACH from standard ACH. And we only change one thing. We're adding a new thing called a clearing object that tells the Dwolla platform, I want this transfer to be included in the next available clearing window. So for same day ACH, we're going to look at all the windows available and fit it into the next window that makes sense for same day. Over here, we're going to refresh again and see new transfer for same day ACH, $210,000. Okay, so done standard and same day. There's other payment modalities. Let's speed it up and go a little bit faster. The next one we wanna do is a push to debit transaction. So we'll kick that off and get it started. What has to change about our programming to get push to debit up and running? Well, it turns out that really the only thing different about sending funds to a debit card is the URL or the funding source, the destination of those ultimate funds. So over here in the sandbox, I'm showing a test card. You can see it's a Visa and I'm pushing funds to that. Only thing I have to change in my program is just the destination URL where I want the funds to go. So we'll look at the transaction itself and we should see a $310,000 push to debit transaction in our sandbox environment. Okay, we got one more. and we're gonna do an RTP transfer. As Ben noted, this is brand new for today. So let's kick off RTP. What changes between pushing funds from a bank account to a bank account over ACH versus RTP? Well, there's not a lot that changes from a programming perspective. It's very little. On the Dwolla platform, it's actually about two lines of code. So we have to change the processing channel from ACH to real-time payments. And when we do that, over here, pulling up in our, again, our Falcon Dwolla, we'll pull up our transactions again, and we'll expect to see a transaction for $97,000 on RTP. While all this is going on, one of the things that's also happening on the Dwolla platform is we're creating and sending webhooks that are associated to the application. So I've created just a little catch bin here that's catching all the webhooks that are happening. So you can see as I've been doing this demo, webhooks have been coming in. So if I was an application programming against here, I could see the customer completed events coming in, the bank transfer completed events, customer transactions created, all the details about what's happening in my application and how it's being interacted with. I think our AI has one more thing to say before we finish this game. Appreciate us, you all giving us the time for the demo. If you're interested in learning more about Dwolla, please check out our dev docs at developers.dwolla.com. Create a sandbox account, sandbox.dwolla.com, and I'll hand it back to the VSUM team.